all kind of kids there. I said, I don't understand. She said, well, just pray about God. God has chosen. I said, reckon we're supposed to start a youth building or something here in Fayetteville? I said, I didn't know, Patty, but I knew what God had chosen. Go to church Wednesday night. I tell everybody, all right, y'all, I just want you to be praying about something because I don't know. Told them about the vision. Told them about all the kids in our church. Told them about it being a red, big red brick building. Well, Sunday morning rolls around, and here we are. LeVon stands up and says, hey, he says, I spotted the building just right down the road here. Says, it's a good block and a half from here. And Sister Sanders says, is it that building down there next to Higgins? She said, yeah. I says, yeah, I spotted that too. I said, she says, so-and-so owns it. I checked into it. So-and-so owns it. He said if we want to look at it, all we got to do is call him. So we voted to go look at it that day after church. We go down there. Big old red brick building. We go in the back side door. Go walk up a ramp. Walk in this place and it's nice. It just got repainted. The carpet and everything to it looked good. Had great big old rooms in it. Man, it was plenty, you know. It was way bigger than where we was at. It was bigger than we needed. I was like, man, that's just nice. Come find out. It was in our budget. We talked about it. We decided right then we'd rent it. He told me I could do whatever I wanted to on the inside. So I told him what I, you know, I was looking and I might do this, I might do that. You know, I'm going to dress it up real good. I like doing trim, but I'm going to make it pretty, you know. I said, not that it ain't pretty now. That's fine right now. We can have church in here, you know. You know what? Same, we moved in there. And while I was working on that place, I heard some of the awful music. Before service, before that Sunday started, I was working there that week, and man, I heard some of the awfulest music. It sounded like devil worship music. It sounded like somebody's playing Leonard Skinner or something down there, you know? I ain't good with music, but I knew it didn't sound like no Christian music. I thought, my goodness, man, if Sandy was up here, she wouldn't want us to have no church here, you know? But I was there by myself with Colin. Colin was in the floor playing with nail gun. And I kept telling him, they leave it alone, boy, you're gonna get hurt. Now don't be messing with that. Every time I turn around, he had that brag gun shooting blocks together. He done shot his hand before I knew it. Of course, Brother Derek got in trouble because I let him shoot and play with him with nail gun. But you know what? Chris come to find out that devilish music was Christian rock music that they was trying to play down there. And it was a youth group set up for youth ministry. And there was all those kids in that big red brick building. Remember that? Yeah. You're talking about setting a fire. Church was on fire then, buddy. Because everybody knew that God had showed that before it ever happened. God is a faith builder. I'm here to tell you, he'll lead, guide, and direct you. Just in getting this building here, he led us here. I promise you, I come out to do some work on a building right down the street. Done worked on this building a year and a half before this. Didn't even recognize the guy that had the building down the street was the same guy that owned this building. And I was down there and working on, I gave him a bid, was working on it. Building down there on a house. And all of a sudden he says, hey, we've been praying for another church. We've been saving money this time. We had over $10,000 saved up to put down on the building or put down on some property just to buy a building. And he says, hey, you looking for a church to buy? I got one. I said, do what? He said, you looking for a church to buy? He said, don't you remember me? I said, am I supposed to? He said, yeah, you worked on the church right down the road here for me here a while back. Had a tornado come through and it wiped the front off. And I had water damage all up there on the front of the building. You fixed the floors up. I said, oh, I said, that building of the Spanish church up here? Yeah, but it ain't no Spanish church no more. Nobody's been in there for a year. I said, really? He said, really? But he said, it's nice. It's nice. He said, it's been took care of. I said, really? I said, what are you asking for? He said, well, I don't know. You want to come look at it? We'll go up there and look at it. Well, that's what got us here. But the whole time, Sister Patty, ever since I had a head-on collision with God, gave my life to him, 1995, November the 20th. I hadn't been the same that I once was. God changed my life, and he continues to lead God and direct me. He's the reason I'm here tonight, and he's the reason that any of y'all are here tonight. Let me tell you tonight, amen, if you'll just lay your life down, Bible says that we'll lay our life down, take up the cross and follow him, we can be his disciple. Don't you want to be a disciple of Jesus Christ? Amen. Have you been born again? Are you lost? Tonight only you can answer that. I've just told you things. I can tell you a lot of other things. But I've told you things that's happened that I know, that I know, that I know. Yeah. It's God. What about you? Where are you at tonight? Have you laid your life down completely and totally to him? Is he your all in all? Do you have a relationship with Jesus Christ? The Bible says that my sheep will know my voice. What about it? See, I could come and get you tonight and tell you that you need to get saved. But that wouldn't do you no good. But if you've heard God tonight and you feel like God's doing that on your heart's table tonight, run to Jesus. Run down here. Kneel before him and just ask him to be Lord and Savior of your life. Let me encourage you. Tell you why Shane's here. Over a year ago, been longer than that now, God told me that Shane and Brandy was going to come and join our church. I told Sister Sandra. And then, you know what? It was like a week later, they showed up at our church. And I thought they was going to start coming. And then they didn't come back. 1 month, right at a month, before Shane called me up, said, brother, we're thinking about coming and visit. God spoke to me, and I told Sister Sandra. I said, Sandra, I said, God spoke to me, and he told me that Shane and Randy was fixing to come here, and Shane was going to be my assistant pastor. She said, well, okay. Like she really believed me, because last time I told her, they came one time and didn't come back. You know what? Right around a month, and all of a sudden, here Shane and Brandy comes. And I wasn't surprised this time because I believed God. And I knew that God was doing something, and I'd been praying, God, I need some help. God, I need somebody that'll come and that we can work together and build the church that you won't build. cent change. Now, Sister Sanders stood right beside me this whole time. She's a powerful woman of God. And I'm not pushing her out by any means. Because I consider her just as much a pastor as me. I knew he needed to.
Now can see.
I'm going to say this. Sister Sandra has been a blessing in my life. And if it weren't for her, I don't know where I'd be. Amen. But God wants to be a blessing to you tonight. Amen. Let me tell you tonight, amen, that Avery wouldn't be here if his daddy wasn't here. But it starts just like that. Kind of like a domino effect. See, those that he can reach, I can't reach. Those that you can reach, I can't reach. And those that I can reach, you can't reach. Not that we can do anything, but the Spirit of God that lives in us can do anything He wants to if we'll become obedient. I promise you, there's nothing He can't do. Hallelujah.
Not with you, but I'm met on the cross. Me and His will say that I can still go free. Well, I need.
It'll I'll eat in the morning, well, like the afternoon, and I'm good for the rest of the day.
Yeah. I just want to make sure that you had a place to go back to, that you had food to eat. Okay? All right, buddy.
Around there, Avery. Let's give Avery a hand clap and welcome him. Come up and welcome him to the kingdom of God. Amen. God's a good God. Amen. Hallelujah. Now I know why I had to get to church. Amen. Praise the Lord. After you see Avery, everyone's dismissed in the name of Jesus.
Six lugs.
Yeah, six lugs.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, the road has a